Welcome back to my playthrough of Super Mario RPG for the Switch. Please check the intro of the first part of this series if you'd like to hear the kinds of commentary I'm going to be making along the way. The cutscene here reminded me that I forgot to give the cricket jam to the frog sage, so excuse me while I go back and do that really quick.
Thank you.
There's a fairly large change to the localization script here that I hadn't seen anyone else mention. I even made a short video about it because it took me off guard so much. Two things to note as I fight through Nimbus Castle. I like that the instrumentation ramps up as you continue getting chain timed attacks in battle. And another thing that I've noticed is that the jawful enemies, which don't attack you until you hit them first, are not affected by splash damage, or rather they don't wake up due to splash damage.
Thank you.
here's where you would get the signal ring in the original. Instead, you now get the Echo signal ring, which shows you exactly where each hidden treasure chest is located. It's kind of useless now, though, because there's only one treasure chest left to get, and it's pretty easy to find. Before I go into the volcano, I'm going to take care of a few things. First up, I wanted to go back into the castle to check out this Metroid reference that was in the original SNES game. Secondly, I'm going to go over and buy the Beatlemania retro arcade game, and then play it for a bit just to show it off, although it's basically unchanged from the original. I'm going to cut out a few minutes of that gameplay because it's frankly not that interesting to watch. And here's the Lazy Shell armor and weapon. These are some of the best pieces of equipment in the game. However, I'm going to try to avoid using the Lazy Shell armor as it removes a lot of the challenge from the game. You'll also notice that I've yet to use a red essence for similar reasons. I am going to use the Lazy Shell weapon on Mario because it is his best weapon. However, my consistent problems with his shell weapon, getting the timing right for them, rather, leads me to believe that I might have to switch to the Ultra Hammer in Endgame because the shells have just not been working for me.
Oh.
Props to the graphical update to the Tsar Dragon battle. I like that they added the lava here. It makes it feel more dynamic and appropriately fiery. We'll be right back. The Axum Rangers fight is typically messy, although here it's even worse for me because I'm trying to get the Thought Peak entries for all of them, and that takes up a lot of turns that I could be using more productively. Thank you.
Thank you.
I like that they kept that. It seems to be a glitch or an oversight that you only get 17 experience from this battle when you'd expect to get a lot more, and they've kept it in the remake. And here we have Peach's ultimate weapon, the frying pan. I'm also doing the setup here for Kulex's battle, although I'm not going to take him on yet, as I'm not prepared for that at all. I will, however, do the last Jinx battle. Thank you. So with the Jinx belt in hand, I think we're at a good stopping point. Be sure to like the video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on the last few parts of this series. Au revoir!